In this video, we will discuss purchasing power parity, sometimes shortened to PPP, and relative purchasing power parity. Unlike the discussion in one of the previous videos on interest rate parity, purchasing power parity is generally not true. The reason interest rate parity works is in many countries, there is a free flow of currency between countries. People in different countries can buy debt instruments in other countries. And there are active futures markets, such as the Chicago Mercantile Exchange, on currency between countries. This makes IRP true. For PPP to be true, you would have to have the free flow of labor across borders, which we largely don't have, and a free flow of goods and other services across borders, which, regardless of the discussion of free trade, the world largely does not have. To give an example, under PPP, the spot exchange rate between the Turkish lira and the dollar should just be the price of a product in the United States divided by the price of an identical product in Turkey. In this example, I give something that varies drastically in price between these two countries, a product those of us who suffer from sinus infections use called Nasonex. The price of Nasonex in the United States is around $350 and available only by prescription. The price of the same product Nasonex in Turkey is $5 and available over the counter. Nasonex is also available in Europe for $5 to $10 by prescription, or in the United Arab Emirates for around $20 over the counter. So if PPP was true, 350 divided by 5 would get an exchange rate of 70 Turkish lira per dollar. In reality, the exchange rate is a little under 4 of 3.84. So PPP gives a drastically incorrect result. Under a free market, what would happen is people would go to Turkey, they would buy Nasonex for $5, and they would sell it in the United States for $350, and they would keep doing this at a hefty profit until the price went up in Turkey and down in the United States. Under our current system, both UPS and FedEx have been prosecuted for allowing people to import these products from other countries, and if you tried to do this yourself, you would probably be arrested for practicing medicine without a license. So the lack of the ability for these goods to flow across borders makes PPP not true. The same thing applies to things like labor. Labor gets paid a lot more in the United States than Mexico and a lot more in countries like Norway than the United States, but it is illegal in many cases for Mexicans to come to the U.S. to work or for Americans to go to Norway to work. And these rules, again, prevent PPP from being true. Relative purchasing power parity is very similar in appearance to the equation for interest rate parity. Again, we have a future dollar, in this case, Turkish lira exchange rate equals a spot dollar Turkish lira exchange rate times, now rather than 1 plus the interest rate to the number of years, we have 1 plus the inflation rate in dollars to the number of years, divided by 1 plus the expected inflation rate in Turkish lira to the number of years. For an example, we look at the current spot Turkish lira dollar exchange rate, since our equation up here has dollars per Turkish lira, and the quote we have off the internet is Turkish lira per dollars, the first thing we have to do is invert this number. So we merely invert 3.84, and we get the current spot dollar Turkish lira exchange rate is 0.26. Now we use our equation to try and predict from relative PPP what the future dollar Turkish lira exchange rate will be. We take our 0.26, sticking it in here as D20, and then we look at the estimates of inflation in the United States over the next 2 years of 3%, and in Turkey of 10%, and we have 1.03 squared divided by 1.1 squared. This gives a predicted future dollar Turkish lira exchange rate in 2 years of around 0.23. Note this means in 2 years it takes fewer dollars to buy a Turkish lira than it does today. This is because the inflation rate is higher in Turkey than the United States, which may indicate the Turkish central bank is printing more currency than the U.S. central bank. Well, these equations don't tend to be very accurate in predicting future dollar Turkish lira exchange rates. Over the very long run, PPP tends to start drifting to be true. This is because even though you have barriers to labor crossing borders, cheap labor from Mexico will come to the United States. And even though you have barriers to buying Nasonex in Europe and selling it into the United States, some people will still do that. Others will go from the United States to Mexico for healthcare, from the United States to Canada or to Europe for healthcare. Also, factories in high labor countries tend to relocate to low labor countries. So over the long run, PPP does tend to give some prediction in which way prices are going to go. Thank you for watching this video.